What if you could see and manage all your tasks and appointments from various sources, including Obsidian, in one place? Well, now you can. Today, I will show you the future, well, at least one possible future, in which you can easily aggregate your private and work calendars as well as your to-do lists and tasks from various sources, including Obsidian, of course. We will see a tool called Morgen, centralizing all this information and making it available to us on any device. We will also learn how easy it is to set this up and how seamlessly it works in real life. Speaking of learning, if you like learning new things or refreshing things you used to know, as much as I do, you will most likely enjoy Brilliant. Since I started using it, I spent much less time doom scrolling or checking YouTube statistics. Instead, I fire up Brilliant, the sponsor of today's video. Brilliant makes it easy to learn anywhere right on your phone, with thousands of interactive lessons in math, data analysis, programming, and AI. The data analysis course is one of my personal favorites, but their ever-growing catalog covers a wide range of topics. Brilliant helps build your critical thinking skills through problem solving, not memorizing. So while you are building real knowledge on specific topics, you will also be becoming a better thinker. Brilliant recently launched a ton of new data science content, all of which uses real-world data to train you to see trends and make better informed decisions. Learn how to parse and visualize massive datasets to make them easier to interpret. Gain insight by working with real datasets from sources like Airbnb, Spotify, Starbucks, and more. To try everything Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 30 days, visit brilliant.org/leanproductivity or scan the QR code on screen. Or you can also click on the link in the description. With this, you will also get 20% off an annual premium subscription. Before we jump into the specific integration with Obsidian, let's make sure we understand Morgen a little bit better. Morgen is a platform and an application that helps us aggregate all our tasks and appointments from various sources into one central location. This aggregation is not just a few across different apps. Morgen actively connects and synchronizes data, ensuring real-time updates and minimizing the need to constantly switch between platforms. For me, it looks like this. Starting with tasks, I currently see all the tasks from Morgen itself, my private Outlook, my private Microsoft To-Do, the company's Microsoft To-Do with Microsoft Planner behind it, and of course from Obsidian. Other task sources that I'm not using myself but can also be integrated include Notion, ClickUp, Linear, Todoist, and Google Tasks. I also synchronize multiple calendars. In my case, the company's Outlook calendar and my personal Outlook calendar. Other available integration options include Google Calendar, Exchange, Fastmail, iCloud, other CalDev-based calendars, and even subscription services. As you can see, this allows me to easily view all my tasks and prevent scheduling conflicts across my calendars. Obviously, I don't want my private appointments in my work calendar and vice versa, but I need to consider them for planning my day effectively. Morgen's unified view and automatic propagation helps me do just that. More about that one a little bit later. Admit it, that's pretty nice. It also raises the question how we can get this super fast and seamless integration to work. You have come to the right place. Let me show you step by step. Quick disclaimer though, Morgen comes quite literally with a ton of great features and the team behind it releases updates and new versions very frequently. As I cannot cover them all in this video, let me know in the comments if you're interested in a dedicated one about Morgen itself. For this one, I will focus on those that are most relevant to Obsidian users like you and me. First, we need a couple of plugins. Probably to nobody's surprise, we will start with the Tasks plugin. We go to Settings, Community Plugins, and click on Browse. Here we search for Tasks, install the plugin, and enable it. Then we jump right into the plugins options page and make sure that the task format is set to Task Emoji Format. The rest of the settings is up to you. Personally, I like to differentiate real tasks by adding the tag To Do. This helps me to ignore other items like checklists in my notes. Next, we need the Morgen Tasks plugin to let Obsidian and Morgan identify and synchronize tasks. Once again, we go to Community Plugins, Search, Install, Enable the plugin, and go to its options. Here we can choose whether we want to see task IDs, hide them completely, or replace them with an emoji. Personally, I like to hide them completely, just to declutter my notes a little bit. Next, we move over to Morgan. After creating an account, we will see our dashboard, including a button to download the Morgan desktop app. We do that, install it, and sign in to the app. Once this is done, we click on our profile picture, preferences, and under local integrations on Obsidian. As long as we do not have a vault connected, there will be a button called Connect a Vault. We click on it and select our vaults folder. I have done this already, as you can see. Once connected, we have plenty of options to customize which tasks should be synchronized to Morgan. We can include or exclude notes by default, and then use additional rules to fine-tune this. In my case, I start with include notes by default. Then I define some excluded directories like my inbox, my templates, etc. And I also tell Morgan to ignore notes that have not been modified in the last 30 days. Additionally, I use the previously mentioned tag to-do to make sure I only synchronize real tasks. Obviously, your setup might and will look different. But you can see that we have plenty of options to optimize the synchronization. At the end of these settings, we can tell Morgan to only import tasks that already have a unique ID, or to add IDs to tasks automatically. This is necessary for Morgan to sync tasks and the updates properly. As mentioned, Morgan is not just viewing tasks from Obsidian, but we can also update them in Morgan directly. That's why I like to enable the option to set the done date of tasks in Obsidian if I complete them in Morgan. And that's it in a nutshell. If you need or want more details regarding these rules and criteria, check the excellent guide on the Morgan homepage. As always, I left the link to it for you in the description. Now that the integration is done, let me show you how seamlessly Obsidian and Morgan work together. Here we have an empty node in Obsidian and my Obsidian task list in Morgan, which is also empty at the moment. Let's start by adding a new task to our Obsidian vault. Right away, we see that nothing happens. That's because in my personal setup, not every item that is technically a task in Obsidian is really a task for me. I also use task items for checklists, for example. So, I configured the Tasks plugin to only recognize task items that have the tag to-do. Let me add the to-do tag to our first task and voila, it shows up in Morgan pretty much immediately. By the way, you might be wondering why we still see the task ID although we configured the Morgan Tasks plugin to hide it. Well, that's because we're currently working in preview mode. If we switch to read mode, then the IDs disappear completely. I created a few tasks here and we can see them in Morgan too. Here I can mark them as complete and the change, including the done date as configured, is synchronized to Obsidian right away. Bonus tip for you. Having our tasks in Morgan makes scheduling them super easy. We can simply drag one from our list and drop it onto the calendar. Here we can adjust the task duration to make sure we block enough time for it. And once we're done, we can simply check it off directly in the calendar view too. Pretty neat, right? So that works pretty well with simple tasks. But what about recurring tasks or tasks with subtasks? Well, let's find out. Let's go back to our demo node. We will add a recurring task here for taking out the trash every Monday. It starts next Monday, based on today's recording date, and is due every Monday. We do not define an end date. We suppose we are not going to run out of trash anytime soon. Initially, this task does not look all that different from the normal ones, and if we go to Morgan, we can see it added in our list as due on Monday. But if we check this task as complete in Morgan, then it will not only be updated in Obsidian. Obsidian will also automatically create a new one due on the next Monday, which also shows up in Morgan then, of course. And this also works if we decide to mark the task complete in Obsidian. It is perfectly synchronized either way. No matter where you mark a recurring task as done, the change will be reflected instantly in both platforms. By the way, You may have noticed that adding due dates to our Obsidian tasks automatically shows these tasks at the top of the respective day in Morgan. So, even if the task pane is closed, we can see them and block time for them on the calendar. And now, let's see how this works with main tasks and subtasks. Once again, we create some demo tasks. In this case, there are two main tasks with two subtasks each. As we would expect, this synchronizes nicely to Morgan. As before, we can now mark our main or subtasks as complete in Obsidian or in Morgan. Note that marking a main task as done does not automatically close the related subtasks. Again, this works very nicely. If I have one wish, then that is to show the relationship between Obsidian main and subtasks in the same way they do it for native Morgan tasks. If we create main and subtasks natively in Morgan, we get this little tree structure, making it much easier to see which subtasks belong to each main task. If they could do something like this for Obsidian tasks, this would make me very happy. I mentioned earlier that I cannot cover all of Morgan's features, but I really want to mention a few highlights that I find very helpful. I feel like they would be beneficial for many of you too, so here we go. When talking about calendar aggregation, I also mentioned automatic propagation. Let's take a look at that one. Morgan comes with a feature called workflows. This includes one that lets us define a source calendar and a target calendar. Based on these settings, Morgan will automatically propagate the target calendar with any entries in the source calendar without sharing any details. In my case, my private calendar is the source and my work calendar is the target. And that's all we really need to define. However, there is also a nerd mode, which lets us customize the appearance of propagated events in the target calendar. In my case, I change the event title to busy and the privacy to private. If I need some time off for a personal appointment, I can simply add it to my private calendar. Morgan will then automatically create an entry in my work calendar as out of office or busy without revealing the actual reason for my absence. This helps me maintain clear boundaries between my work and personal life while ensuring my colleagues are aware of my availability or lack thereof. Morgan also offers several other workflow templates, such as calculating travel time or adding buffer time between meetings automatically. And several more are still to come. There is another service included in Morgan that I find incredibly valuable. It's booking page functionality. I used to pay for a separate service to get this, but now I can save that money by using Morgan's built-in feature. With just a few clicks, we can create booking pages for meetings, complete with scheduling options and automated reminders. This seamlessly integrates with my existing calendars, ensuring that appointments are properly reflected across all the platforms. I can share links to my booking pages and let people find slots that fit their availability. And if you want to let people pick only one of a very specific set of time slots, you can use the open invites feature. Once again, this is very simple to use and a real time saver. We simply go to Morgan, select a time slot on our calendar, give the event a title, and then click on open invite. Now we can select additional time slots in the calendar. When we are done, we click on create and copy link. We can then send this link to the attendees. Once they click on it, they will get a custom version of a booking page, offering only the defined slots for booking an appointment. Once they book a slot, it will automatically be added to our calendar. Morgan does not only come as a desktop app, but also has a mobile version that allows you to stay on top of your tasks and schedule even when you are away from your computer. The mobile app mirrors the functionality of its desktop counterpart, letting you view your calendar, manage tasks, and update the status seamlessly across devices. Additionally, there's a really handy widget that can be added to your home screen on iOS or Android. The widget currently shows upcoming events from all our connected calendars. In the app itself, we can also see our tasks, booking links, and of course, various calendar views. It's really convenient for quickly checking your schedule or marking a task as complete on the go. The calendar comes with various views to suit different preferences and needs, and creating new tasks or events is very straightforward. At the time of recording this video, it was not yet possible to see all Obsidian tasks in the mobile app. However, the request for this feature is already under review by the team. And if this is important to you, you can upvote it at the Morgan roadmap, the link to which is once again in the description. Apart from this specific request, that website is a great place to see what is coming next to Morgan. The team behind Morgan is small and dedicated. They release updates and new versions very frequently and are always willing to listen to their users. Sounds familiar? Yep. That's very much like the Obsidian team does it. I really hope this video helps you understand how Morgan can help with many aspects of organizing work and time, and especially how useful it can be for working with Obsidian tasks. If so, perhaps drop a like, subscribe to the channel, and ring the notification bell to make sure you won't miss the next videos. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and you may want to check out this video next.